Welcome to the second annual SONUS International Music Festival, bringing you world premiere performances from studios and concert halls from around the world. Now sit back and enjoy Romances and Remembrances.
Welcome to our fourth night of the SONUS International Music Festival. Our program tonight is called Romances and Remembrances. In Spanish, Romances y Recuerdos. Guastavino has a long history with the romances. The romances originally were a poetic form from Spain, from the 1500s or 1400s. And these were long poems, often epic in nature, that were transmitted orally through several centuries. And they basically discuss and introduce historical events and heroes, just in the same way as many other forms in Europe at the time. So Guastavino felt attracted to this form because it gave him the opportunity to write music that was a little bit longer than the usual character piece, and music that had some sort of relationship with history and with tradition of his own country. So he wrote romances throughout his life, starting in the early 1940s and until actually the late 1960s. And some of these romances are for voice, others are just instrumental. The program tonight includes the two romances called Nuevos Romances or Romances Nuevos. The first one is La Niña del Río Dulce and the second El Chico que Vino del Sur. We don't really know who these characters were, but they are obviously tied to the land because they actually make reference to specific places in Argentina, and they use traditional folk genres, specifically dances or song genres, that you can hear very clearly. The program also includes a movement of tres romances for two pianos, Baile en Cuyo. And again, this is a piece that makes reference to a specific place in Argentina, in this case, the Mendoza province and the Cuyo region in western Argentina. The program tonight also includes the premiere of one of the finalists for the composition competition. We chose this piece to be featured tonight because of the relationship to the land. The composer, Gabriel Abedi, writes using some of the folk genres of his motherland, basically Ghana and the Yue people. So we thought this was a very interesting relationship and the same kind of relationship that you find in Guastavino music featured tonight. The program also includes the first guitar sonata, and this is a piece that was dedicated to his recently deceased brother. So it's a piece that has a very strong emotional content, and thus the name Remembrances or Recuerdos. So I hope that you will enjoy the program tonight. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Javier, ¿tienes alguna conexión personal con esta obra?
Bien, con la sonata, la primera sonata de Guastavino, mi conexión es a través de mi maestro de guitarra principalmente. Si bien la obra, yo la estudié, bueno, a fines de los años 90, ya era una obra importante y reconocida entre los guitarristas, el hecho de que mi maestro Vicente Elías sea amigo, cercano de Carlos Guastavino, me dio la oportunidad de tener otra visión, otra dimensión de lo que significaba la obra y un acercamiento a la personalidad de Guastavino como creador, como persona. Bueno, la sonata 1 de Guastavino es una obra muy importante dentro del repertorio argentino y también dentro del repertorio universal para guitarra. Dentro del argentino hay pocas obras y pocos antecedentes de obras de esa envergadura, tanto por la complejidad de la obra. Hablábamos de complejidad, no en el sentido solamente de dificultad técnica que la tiene, y es un desafío para nosotros guitarristas, pero también en la profundidad del mensaje. Al ser una obra tan estructurada formalmente, da la oportunidad de profundizar en este mensaje que nos transmite Guastavino, de lo que es su visión de la música argentina, de los elementos que reflejan a las personas de nuestro país a través de sus ritmos folclóricos y esta relación, una síntesis que hace él personal y muy lograda entre lo que es el espíritu del folclore, de las formas y de lo popular, junto con la estructura formal de la música europea, ¿no? Y de lo que es la formación de Guastavino, de todos sus estudios a través de los grandes maestros, ¿no? Y entonces él logra como hacer un plasmar en su obra un mensaje muy profundo en ese sentido. Thank you.
Thank you. The fifth finalist we present to you hails from Italy and Ghana. This is Gabriel Abedi and his composition, Agbadza.
Hi, my name is Gabriel Abedi, and I am one of the finalists of the 2021 Carlos Guastavino Composition Competition. The piece that I have wrote and that you're about to hear is called Agbadza. It's a composition for piano solo, and it is inspired by a traditional music and dance from the Ewe people, an ethnic group from West Africa. The largest population of the Ewe people is in Ghana, and from my mother's side, I am an Ewe. When I was a kid, my mom used to sing me some Ewe folk tunes that are used to put the kids to sleep, and as I grew up, I heard them being sung to my little sister too. I have always found this melody fascinating, and when I started composing, I had the natural desire to study the traditional music of the Ewe people and integrate it into my style. I wish you enjoy the piece. Thank you. Thank you.
Tell us about these songs that you'll be singing for us.
In this particular case, I'm doing two songs that I never performed before. Two songs that are seldom performed. Déjame esta voz, which is a song composed in the early 40s by Guastavino. And the second one is Elegía para un gorrión, written in the 60s. One has a little bit more of a classical structure. The second one is more nationalistic, if you want to say. And I'm very excited because these are two very different songs and they are a challenge, not only vocally, but musically. They are very, very complex and very beautiful, of course.
How were they chosen?
When we talked with Nancy about this project, she gave me a few ideas and she mentioned Elegía para un Gorrión. And I said, okay, let me look at this because I never heard of this song before. So I find a recording and start listening to it and say, wow, this is really fantastic.
Compared to some of the other stuff in your repertoire, how do you approach Guastavino's work differently than, or do you?
Well, in the case of Déjame esta voz particularly, the structure is, it takes a while to really understand. And this poem is full of dramatism and sadness. And I think Guastavino really likes and found something very, a lot of meaning into it, and he decided to write it.
Déjame esta voz que tengo, lo mismo que a la pampa le dejan sus matorrales de deseo, sus ríos secos colgando de las piedras.
Of course, Elegía, it has nothing to do with Déjame esta voz. Guastavino becomes more in contact with the folklore in Argentina, with folklorists in Argentina, that all the artists that were recording back then. And in this particular song, he writes on the poetry of Alma García, which is a folklorist and a poet from my hometown, from Tucumán. The music here, it has a totally different character. And the poetry speaks about the death of a bird, basically, right? And the sentiment depicts the loss of this life and how its environment reacts to it, how the wind reacts to it, how the tree where this bird lived feels about that loss. Is so fantastic, and it's, you can feel it and hear it in this chromatic melodies, descending chromatic melodies, for example. In my experience as a singer, I start always with the text, and I think it's important because we need to understand that composers in general, and particularly Guastavino, put a lot of attention to the meaning and deep meaning of the words before writing the music for it. You will find all the answers in this beautiful poetry, and you will understand clearly what this great composer wrote. The melodies are really a lot of accidentals. The piano complements the voice in such an incredible way, but they are very different, because the melodies are very diatonic while the piano is very complex in its structure. Yes.
Thank you so much for joining us today. SONUS relies on contributions of people like you to help make this festival and competition possible. Your contribution of any amount will help us continue in our mission to disseminate the music of these wonderful artists. Please visit our website, www.sonusinternationalmusicfestival.org, to make your tax-deductible contribution today. Thank you.